Hello once again. Now in this video we'll be looking at classification of contracts. So we have got a couple of classifications under the law of contracts. First you have got expressed and implied contracts. We also have got unilateral and bilateral contracts. Number three, we have got valid, void and voidable contracts. We also have got speciality and simple contracts. There's also contract of record. We also have got executed contracts. Next, we have got executory contracts. We also have got quasi contracts. So we'll be looking at the contracts one at a time because it's a very common question. Differentiate between valid, void and voidable contracts, or differentiate or give the differences between valid and or unilateral and bilateral contracts, or executed and executory contracts. So contracts or other. So number one, we have got expressed and implied contracts. So what is this? So an expressed contract is one in which parties specifically agree about the nature of terms and relationship. So it's expressed, meaning people have to express themselves, get to talk and agree with one another. And then on the other hand, there is no specific agreement in an implied contract. So in this part, people express themselves and they're able to agree. In implied, there is no agreement. Number two, we look at unilateral and bilateral contracts. So what are these? A unilateral contract is one in which only one party is bound. When you talk of uni, is one party. Bilateral, both parties are bound. Meaning in this, there's only one person that has got the upper hand. Over here, both of the parties have got the upper hand and they're able to express themselves willingly. And then we have got valid, void and voidable. A very common question. Explain the difference between valid, void and voidable contracts. So what do we have now? What's a valid contract? It's an agreement that is enforceable by law. An agreement becomes enforceable by law when all the essentials of a valid contract are discussed above. Meaning valid, it's valid, meaning it's enforceable by law. Now a void contract is one in which an agreement is not binding. It's void, from the name it's void, meaning it's not binding. And then lastly, a voidable contract is one in which is enforceable by law by the option of one party. It's similar to valid, but then it's only enforceable by law at the option of one party. Maybe you didn't supply goods, so the other party opted to sue you or take you to the police station. So it's enforceable by law at the option of only one party, meaning the other party only wanted you to talk out and agree whether they can resupply you with goods or do something, or you talk minus including the law into it. And then we have got speciality contracts and simple contracts. So what's a speciality contract? A speciality contract is also known as a contract under a seal. It's an instrument in which it's signed and sealed. When we talk of it's signed and sealed, the contract is written, signed, put in an envelope and sealed. So it's a contract that is sealed. On the other hand, we have got simple contracts, and you say, now this is an agreement expressed or implied which gives rise to legal obligation. Now a simple agreement may be in writing or agreed orally. So both of you, you receive vegetables or you bake a cake for someone, or you do an event And you agree orally, it's quite simple, you don't need any detailed sealing and documentation. This only comes when you trust either your supplier or whoever is paying you money. Now, the following contracts must be evidence in writing. Whenever you're getting into such a contract, always ensure that it is in writing. Number one, you have got contract of guarantee. There is contract of sale of land. You always have to do that in writing. There is contract of sale of goods. Any sale of goods above 200 shillings has to be in writing, meaning you have to do some documentation. That can either be in form of a receipt, maybe you sell food to someone, and then of course someone has to pay, and then you write a receipt for the sale. Employment contract over 1 month. When you're getting into unemployment, be it a casual job or someone is taking you into employment, you always have to write down something. And then you have got hire purchase contracts and money lending contract. If you're getting into a deal, maybe it's a supplier, or maybe you're lending money or you're borrowing money, you have to do that in writing. Now, next we look at contract of record. So why do we say it's a contract of record? Now, a contract of record consists of the judgment of a court, such as, now such contracts are formed by an entry in the court records, meaning for you to get into a contract with someone, you have to present yourself before a judge, and then you get to write or do all the documentation so that the records are in the courts. And then next we look at executed and executory contracts, or rather. So what's an executed contract from the name? Now, a contract is said to be executed when both parties to the contract have completely performed the duties, meaning both parties, you and the supplier, have done their part, so the contract has been executed. And then you have got executory contract, which simply says that it's one in which both the obligations are understanding. Now, one on either party to the contract, either wholly or in part, at time of the formation of the contract. Now, in other words, a contract is said to be executory when either both the parties to the contract have still not yet performed their duties. Now, you told your supplier to supply vegetables by 6, they were never supplied. You told someone from City Market to supply you with 100 pieces of fugu, they haven't been supplied. So yes, there was a writing in form of a contract, but then the contract has not been executory or has not been done by either one party. And lastly, we look at quasi-contracts and types of contracts or classification of contracts. So this is the type of contract that has got no or little affinity with the contract. Like a quasi partner, he does nothing. You only need to use the name. Now, such a contract does not arise by virtue of any agreement expressed or implied, because we had looked at what an expressed or implied contract is. So, meaning this is like a dormant partner. So, that's all for contracts.